patients with cancer, opioids can be highly useful for dealing with moderate to severe cancer pain that stems from the cancer itself or from the treatment of cancer. So the risk of dependency can be high when using opioids. So we recommend that patients have a plan for pain management once they become a survivor of cancer. So that could be, if necessary, with the use of opioids, or it could be with a more holistic approach, which is what we recommend. So the prevalence of pain is not really well known, especially among survivors of cancer. Prior studies have indicated that the prevalence was anywhere from 5 to 56%, which is really a wide range. So we thought this was an important study to do because we wanted to understand the opioid use rate among survivors of cancer and how it compares to matched controls who've had no prior cancer diagnosis. We conducted the study at the Institute for Clinical Evaluative Sciences, and we received health records of 8,600 individuals who had survived cancer for at least 5 or more years past their cancer diagnosis. We then matched them one-to-one with controls who had no prior cancer diagnosis. Now, everybody in the cohort was eligible for ODB, which is the Ontario Drug Benefit Program, and this is available to anybody who on social assistance or whose drug cost is high relative to their actual household income. We looked at the time period of 2010 and 2012. Now, over that time period, we tried to understand the opioid use rate among survivors against the controls. We want to account for varying factors, demographic factors including age, socioeconomic status, whether they lived in rural or urban areas, as well as factors of the cancer patients, such as the type of cancer diagnosis and how many years they were past their cancer diagnosis. So among survivors of cancer, we actually see that the rate of opioid use is 22% higher compared to those individuals who have had no prior cancer diagnosis. Even more surprising was that for survivors who had passed 10 or more years from their diagnosis, we saw that their rate of opioid use was still higher against individuals who've had no prior cancer diagnosis. So that really persisted over time. When we examined various types of cancers more closely, we found that survivors of breast cancer did not have significantly higher rates of opioid use compared to individuals without a prior cancer diagnosis. However, for survivors of lung cancer, gastrointestinal cancer, genitourinary cancer, we found that their rates were significantly higher for opioid use compared to those individuals without a prior cancer diagnosis. So we know that survivors of cancer have higher rates of opioid prescriptions. Factors that could be causing that could be treatments that were received during the actual acute diagnosis phase, and perhaps the side effects of these treatments lingering on once survivorship is reached. In addition, survivors of cancer have a higher risk of other diseases such as osteoporosis, which may require more intense pain management therapies. Ideally, the primary care provider is involved from the beginning. It's possible that for certain patients, for certain types of diagnoses, that occurs more frequently than others. Having the primary care provider involved from the start, continuing on even after survivorship, it really gives them a full sense of the prior history and what's kind of expected in the future. Because otherwise, what's happening is that, you know, after the 5-year mark, typically after a patient reaches survivorship, they are discharged from the oncology clinic, they then go see their primary care provider for most of their care, and it's kind of like a whole new slate, right? So we would like the primary care provider ideally to be involved from the beginning, but if not, if they see lingering opioid use among their patients, it's a good idea to try to examine, you know, why is this really happening? Is it due to actual pain? Is it due to an addiction that could have stemmed from the past? And once they look at that, maybe offering more holistic or integrative approaches to dealing with pain management. So in addition to having a primary care provider take care of you, it may be nice for survivors of cancer to have a larger team, a more specialized team that handles their pain management, that can offer a more integrative and a more holistic approach. It could be individuals that recommend physical therapy, exercise, psychosocial activities, acupuncture, etc. future work consists of examining these survivors more closely. We want to understand what types of treatments they actually received during their treatment phase for cancer. Are there particular types of treatment which require more heavy opioid use, which then results in more addiction, as an example? So we want to be able to understand the main factors that are associated with this higher opioid use among these patients specifically.